are you doing? Welcome to this channel. In case you are new, karibu sana. My name is Miss Kenya, and if you are new, kindly do consider subscribing because I have lots of content lined up for you. And today is on a Tuesday and it's around 5:30, and tomorrow being a work day, I want to prep dinner early so that we can eat early and sleep early. And I want to make black beans, commonly known as njahe here in Kenya. And I know you might be wanting to click off this video just by the mention of njahe, because I know most people dislike njahe. Some even think that jahes should be sold in hardwares, but don't click off this video yet, because I want to show you a recipe that will leave you loving jahe. Personally, I didn't like njahe at all, but my partner loves njahe, so I had to come up with a recipe that had to accommodate both of us, and I ended up loving njahe. Nowadays, I usually make them at least once a week, because I can even make them 3 times a week. So if you are that kind of a person, that used to be me, and I will show you a recipe that will leave you loving njahe. So let's get into it.
So guys, we will start from here. I have other njahes in the fridge, but I felt like this process, this stage was very important. So I have put 2.5 cups of njahe in here, and I have used 6 cups of water. For me, it's better that the water remains than the water dries up before the njahe are ready. And for this step, what I usually do, njahe have a very earthy taste that most people dislike. So what I do, I boil my njahe with garlic. In here, I have chopped 6 cloves of garlic. The cloves were a bit small, that is why it looks like this. So I will put the garlic in, of course, and I have chopped 1 onion, and I have made sure that the size is large. As you can see, it's very large, so I will put the onion in here. I love boiling my njahe with onion and garlic to subdue the earthy taste a little bit, because for me, I love my njahe flavorful and at the same time the earthy taste reduced. So that is what I'm going to do. Of course, I am using my pressure cooker. This is the pressure cooker insert, and you guys, if you don't have a pressure cooker, you should invest in one, because this one is a lifesaver, and I'm not even lying. This one, I'm so happy I bought this pressure cooker. For 2.5 cups, using 6 cups of water, I am going to set time, of course, and for this one, it doesn't have the time for njahe, so I'm going to set that manually. And for njahe, I will set 40 minutes. I usually boil my njahe for 40 minutes because njahe are harder compared to beans and dengu and all that. And the more cooked they are, the better it is, especially for stews. So we will let this boil for 40 minutes. 40 minutes is not a lot of time. So we will let it boil, and then we will be back with the second part of the recipe. For the ingredients, I'm going to be using 1 big green capsicum, 2 tomatoes that are very ripe. I'm going to be using 2 carrots, and then I'm going to be using 2 onions. You can use 1, but personally, I love using a lot of onions, especially in legumes. I'm also going to be using garlic, and I will just use 2 cloves because, remember, I have used some garlic to boil the njahe. For the spices, I'll be using cumin. I'll be using bay leaves, very, very, very important. I'll be using tomato paste. This one is not as important because you have tomatoes. And then I'll be using nutmeg. For the rest of the spices, you can skip them, but I would prefer that you use bay leaves. And then in here, I have, this is dania stalk or dania stem. I don't know why I keep calling them stalk. Dania stems, and this is dania. I will be using, this is dania. I'll be using a little bit of this. This is how I preserve my dania, so don't be worried. I preserve it this way so that it can stay fresh for long. This one is 1 week in now and it's still very fresh. So let's get into this. And then one more thing, using ghee. I prefer using ghee instead of cooking oil, especially in jahe. I told you that jahe have a very earthy taste that you have to play around to bring the flavor out and reduce the earthy taste. This is one of the things that I love using ghee. And let's get into prepping the ingredients. I told you I prefer using ghee to cooking oil, but you can use cooking oil. There is no problem. I will heat a microwave of ghee, and then, as you can see, my ghee is hot. So when the ghee is hot, I will add my onion. As you can see, I have used two onions, but I know you had seen that when I was prepping the ingredients. I will wait until the onion is translucent so that I can add my garlic. I want to wait until it turns golden brown, but that is the color that I want it to turn into. But before then, I will wait until it's translucent and then I will add in my garlic. You can see my onion is now translucent. So I'm going to add in my garlic. And also at this point, I'm also going to add some dania stems. And then I will mix it properly. And the smell of this is nice. Nice is another statement. So I will mix everything and then I will wait until the onion turns golden brown so that I can add the rest of the ingredients. But for now, this is how it's looking. So let's wait until this turns golden brown. So at this point, I'm going to add in my green capsicum and my tomatoes. And also, I'm going to add salt to taste. Just a little bit of it. And I'm also going to add one bay leaf. Actually, I should have added this when I put in the onion, but I forgot. But that is not a problem. I can add it at this point. Just one leaf. One leaf is enough. Actually, that one is big. This size. I'm going to add one leaf of bay leaf. You can add it at the initial stage when you are adding the onion to the dish. And then I will mix everything and I will wait until the tomato has cooked completely, and when it has started to form a deep paste, and then I will add in the rest of my ingredients. As you can see, my tomato is totally cooked and it has formed a very thick base. This is what I wanted. At this point I will add in my carrots, and of course I will mix everything. Carrots are a very, very important ingredient for me, for my jahe. So at this point I'm going to add cumin. And I'm not going to use a lot. This spoon is enough. I love cumin in all my legumes. Actually, I love it even in my beans. I love it. And then I will cover this and allow it to cook for around 5 minutes so that the carrot can absorb the taste of the rest of the ingredients, because I don't want it to be flat. I don't want it to taste like carrot dipped in this sauce. I want it to marry with the rest of the ingredients. So I will cover this 5 minutes and then I will be back. So this is how my base is looking. I'm sure the carrot is ready now. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add in my black beans and my jahe. This is a very easy meal to prep and to make, by the way, very easy to make. So I will mix it with the rest of the ingredients. And at this point, the only spice that I haven't used is this nutmeg. So I'm going to put it, and I'm going to use this amount to double it, not a lot of it. And then I'm going to mix it, of course. And then I will cover this for like 10 minutes, even before I add water. I know some people love making the base and then putting some water and then putting the jahe, but for me, I like mixing the base and the jahe even before I can put water, for it to absorb all the flavors of the other ingredients. So I will allow it to do that and then I will be back. So I am back, and at this point this is how my jahe looks. So the other thing that I will do, I will add water, and this is half a cup. At this point you can add the tomato paste if you want, especially if you are putting a lot of soup, but I'm not going to be doing that. So I will put half a cup of water, and off camera I have tasted it and I have adjusted the salt. I have added some salt, but as always you can put salt to taste. So this is the amount of water that I have put. So again, I'm going to allow it to sit for some minutes, to simmer for some minutes. Of course, I'm going to reduce the heat. I have done that, and then I will let this simmer for some minutes. I don't want it to be very soupy. That is why I have just added half a cup, because I don't want it to be a river.
I wanted to just have kidogo soup like that. So I will cover up. I will cover it up for 2 minutes, and I will be back for the final stage. So at this point, this is how my njahe looks. As you can see, the soup is thick, so there is no need of putting tomato paste. And you can use tomato paste, you can crush some of the black beans, or you can use any thickening agent. You can also use a potato, but my soup is thick, so there is no need of that. And at this point, I'm going to add in my coriander, all my dania, mix it up. I'm going to mix everything. And that is it. I am done. This is ready to serve. You can serve it with chapos. I love it with chapos, but today I am serving it with rice because that is what I have made. And this one is delicious. If you try it out, let me know on the comment section below. You can also give us your recipes of how you make your njahes on the comment section below. But you should try out this recipe just the way I made it. Make sure you boil your njahes for at least 1 hour, 40 minutes. Allow it to cook. And then boil it with garlic and onions, especially if you dislike the earthy taste. You will love it. You will love it. So let me plate it and I will be right back. So guys, that is it about this recipe. If you try it out, let me know how it turns out to be for you. And share it out with your friends. Also, let me know whether you like njahe or you dislike it. And let me know whether you will try out the recipe or not. Also, remember to give this video a thumbs up, comment on the comment section below, share it out with your friends. And this is how my njahe looks, by the way. It is delicious. I have already tested it and I love it. I love it. Also, if you dislike the earthy taste kabisa kabisa, you can add lemon zest or a piece of lemon, like lemon juice, a piece of lemon or lemon zest. And you can also make it curry by adding curry powder and milk, coconut milk, and I am sure you will love it. So let me see you on my next video. Bye.